with, am I right, Brad, without saying the wrong name, Stevie Nicks?
Yeah,
okay, it's the right thing for a change, huh?
Yes.
Well, here it is, Mr. Walter Egan, Magnet and Steel, back to 1970s on WABC, I mean WPAT. Okay. Okay, stand by from your hotel room, okay?
He can hear it, so which is good.
Good.
What we'll do is, it's 21 minutes into the hour, we can have Bob Ryans put him onto a mini disc or a commercial so he can plug it.
This is the
yeah,
Bob
Weldon. Yeah, so you said cut six.
Yeah.
You want to go back?
Fade into the number three.
Sure.
Fade into the number three. From acapella to
the
radio.
Walk a second.
Oh, I like that live touch. Walter Egan, Magnet and Steel. When I was a kid in 1978, I remember that very well, because Walter Egan, I believe, was born not too far from where I'm from, Jamaica, New York. I was from Suffern, New York. I suffered, but I didn't get out, because I'm still in Suffern all throughout the, all of my years, all of my tender moments, Mr. Brad Williger, right? Here's Walter Egan, just for you.
Hit the post, too, right?
Yeah, George Michael. Good evening, everybody.
This is
okay, we go right back.
What's all about
live radio.
Bob Welch, well, if you ask me, you Bob Welch, well, you know, just committed suicide or something to the man.
And the other one is this new one on the same CD.
Cool.
And that's all. Then we got to go to this fucking game.
What do you want me to ask him about that? Teddy Smith Show and Bob O'Brien. How are you?
I'm great, Teddy. It's great to be on here with you. It's I wrote that just for you, you know.
Well, it's
one of
part
of.
Well, what do you like most about rock and roll, Walter? Or what did you like most about it?
Well, I still love rock and roll.
Ah, thank you.
You're young.
Thank you.
That's what it's all about.
You never get over that thing. I'll tell you, I'll be listening to that. We have thousands of 45s. We have all your great stuff right here with Bob O'Brien. We play it all night here at WPAT, and it's It was great hearing you all the years. Thank you. Thanks to you. You're people like you that make the show happen. Now, you've been out in the world. You've been with Stevie Nicks. You've been with some of the great, great, great people in rock and roll. You want to give us an experience working with Stevie Nicks or anyone else, for that matter?
Well, it was a great thrill for me to work with Stevie. And in fact, you know, Magnet and Steel was written about Stevie. And so it actually kind of, life imitates art, imitates life, with Stevie singing on it. So it was like a closed circuit thrill for me when Stevie got to sing on that list. I have a song called Tunnel of Love that she was recording the background on my first album. The Fundamental Role album on Columbia. And on the way home, after experiencing her doing her banshee wail behind this song of mine, which is probably the most salacious song I've ever written, my grandmother was kind of shocked when she heard it. But on the way home, I was driving behind a car, and it had a license plate that said, "Not Shy." And by the time I got home, I had finished most of the lyrics to that song. So
what cut is it?
It's an amazing kind of thing when things happen cosmically like that. And in my life, it seems like that happens a lot. You know, my middle name is Lindsay, and Lindsay Buckingham, you know, produced my records, and we were both influenced by the Beach Boys and Kingston Trio. And it's, you know, you have too short a show for me to go on and on for all these cosmic things that happened to me. But, you know, it was great working with Stevie and with Lindsay. I got to see Stevie and Lindsay in the same week a couple of weeks ago down in Nashville when they were both separately touring through town.
What was that like? So, how did that go?
It was great. You know, I don't get to see them that often, and it was wonderful. You know, Stevie was really warm, and so was Lindsay. You know, I mean, we spent a lot of time together for about 2-3 years there, and it's really nice to be able to reconnect with them. You know, I think it's great that they're both out there and doing so well. Stevie was opening for Rod Stewart, and Lindsay's doing a solo tour with he and about 45 guitars. it was a thrill team. And then, you know, you mentioned that I worked with Stevie. Well, I've worked with a lot of people over the years.
Like Van Halen, going, right? Steven Tyler.
Actually, Aerosmith was managed by one of my managers back in the day, David Krebs. But I worked, you know, Amy Lou Harris was a good friend of mine. I went to Georgetown University in Washington, D.C. And the first dorm I lived in on campus, I lived in the same dorm as Bill Clinton. So that was pretty bizarre. But
it was quite an experience, I'm sure, yes.
Well, really, the first thing I saw when I was moving into my dorm room was a flyer that said, "This is Clinton country." And he was already running for junior class president at Georgetown, so he hadn't changed a bit, I guess. But one of his classmates and a good friend of mine is Bill Danoff. And Bill, of course, wrote "Take Me Home, Country Roads" and "Afternoon Delight." So we get together every year or so at Georgetown. It's a show by it's called GEMA, G-E-M-A. It's the Georgetown Entertainment Media Alliance, and we put on a show. It's always fun to get together with those people. But
it would be great if you came. Go ahead. I'm sorry, guys.
No, you know, stop me.
I stopped only for the fact that you're such a talent, so unique, that it'd be great if you came into the studio sometime with Eddie Money and jammed together.
Good old Eddie. Yeah, Eddie was on the same label as I when I started out, and he was kind of like a big brother for me for a while, and so it was nice. And I've always been happy for his success through the years, too.
Yeah, it'd be nice for you to play on a live radio show. We could have Brad Willinger, my studio producer, here this evening. Oh, he goes like to every concert that you've been in and every other rock and roll concert for the last 25 years. In fact, I believe that the first concert that you saw was what, by the way?
It was America.
America,
1977,
yeah, to be exact. So yes, exactly. We've got great fans of yours right here in the live studio.
Well, you know, it's going to be one of the first things I do when I come back to town, which hopefully will be not too long from now. I get to go many places. I'm in Atlanta right now. I'm doing this thing called the Yacht Rock Festival, and I'm not sure if you're familiar with the genre called Yacht Rock, but but it's been made popular by Jimmy Fallon and some other people. If you Wikipedia it, you'll find lots of weird things about the yacht rock genre. But there's a band out of Atlanta called the Yacht Rock Review, and they hooked up with me a few years ago, and I sit in with them. Yacht rock basically is the soft rock from the mid-70s to the mid-80s. And so, you know, they recreate it. They do it so well. It's a great band. And they all wear the, you know, appropriate late 70s garb with the kind of polyester suits with the flowered shirts and wide collars and aviator glasses. And, you know, it's a wonderful experience. I think, actually, they do many of these songs better than the originals myself, but... You know, it's only me.
Which hotel are you staying at in Atlanta? You're in Atlanta, you said, right?
Yeah, I'm staying at this kind of boutique hotel that they put me up in called the Ardmore Hotel, which is a very, very nice place here. I just got in this afternoon. But the show's tomorrow night, and also on the bill, this is kind of their gala yearly show. I did this last year with them. And this year they have myself and Gary Wright, the old Dreamweaver, Robbie Dupree.
Steal Away!
Hot Rod
Hearts, Brooklyn Girls.
Peter.
Peter Beckett from Player, you know, Baby Come Back. And what is there the band called Starbuck? Anyway, there's a band.
Moonlight Feels Right by Starbuck?
That's the one, yeah. They've gotten back together for this show. So it's going to be a gala night tomorrow night here in Piedmont Park in downtown Atlanta.
Oh, it's going to be a lot of fun. Say hello to Robbie Dupree. I remember the first time I met Robbie Dupree was at the Joyous Lake in Woodstock, New York in 1980. After that, it was a success story ever since, because Robbie was on a show that I produced years ago at radio station WPLJ, at the time, New York's best rock, believe it or not.
Of course. Yeah, exactly.
Ackerley, Jim Kerr, Tony Pick, Bad St. John.
Valerie Smalldone.
Yeah. Valerie Smalldone, Carol Miller. And who else? Mark Goodman, Mark Coppola.
Dave Charity,
and Bob Maroney. How's that for the lineup?
You got it, yeah. Well, Zachary, of course, had that great show on Channel 9 when we were growing up. Maybe you're too young to remember this, but he did the horror movies on Channel 9 on Friday night. And I wanted to impersonate him on Halloween when I was about 12, 13 years old. And my mother called the station to ask where, you know, we could get a wig that looked like Zachary. And actually, Zachary got on the phone and said, "Madam, that is my own hair."
I'm sure we're going to leave it up to Tim Patrick and Bob O'Brien. We'll have John Zachary. In fact, Bob knows John very well. We're going to have him here for Halloween. Right, Bobby?
Absolutely. Cannot wait.
We're going to play
him. He's great.
The right number?
So, he sent me a Transylvania passport,
which is one of his swag at the time. So, but yeah, so, I grew up, of course, in Queens. I was in Stills, and I went to high school in Manhattan at Loyola School. And the band that I started out in high school is called the Malibus, M-A-L-I-B-O-O-Z, so it wouldn't sound like Malibus when people looked at it. And we played surf music. We played at the World's Fair in 1965. And when I had my success, we were able to do some recording for Rhino Records. We did an album. This was like 1980, I guess. And since then, we've done about four or five CDs. And then in 2 weeks, I'll be joining the Malibus on the West Coast, because we continue to do it every, you know, we keep it going every year, get together once or twice. And we're opening for Dick Dale and the Deltones at the Malibu Inn on August 31st. So that's going to be a legendary show.
How about in New York? Anything with Robbie Dupree up in Woodstock or Bethel, New York, or anything up here?
We're trying to do that. There's a guy who is kind of managing me, and I don't know if you know Pat Horgan or not. But
no other, sure.
Yeah, Pat's been helping me out. He in fact, helped me get this new CD that's now up on iTunes. I have a new CD called Raw Elegance. It's on the Spectra label. And we're still waiting for the hard copies, but you can download it on iTunes. And Pat has been trying to put me together with Robbie for about a year or so now, so hopefully that'll happen. Of course, I'll see him tomorrow. I might see him tonight, actually, so looking forward to that. And so things are good. And, you know, I'm doing as much music as possible.
Hi,
still writing, still performing as much as possible. So, keep
you young. Well, it certainly does. This live show keeps us young and moving, too. More importantly, we're not only just on for this 1 hour. We're on five nights a week here at WPAD and also several other radio stations as well. So Bob O'Brien would like to coordinate some of the other shows that we do or maybe have you live here when you come to New York sometime.
That would be great. I would love to do that. And, you know how to get in touch with me now. So let's stay in touch, and let's try and do that.
Now, when I come to Atlanta, I always get lost on the freeway. I don't know about your experience with that freeway over there. It's quite unique. Every time I go around it, I end up in Birmingham.
Well, the thing is, they drive like maniacs down here, and you have to be in a certain lane, and all of a sudden the lane has passed you, and you're down Mobile, you know? It's like, you got to turn around, and it's pretty crazy. It's a pretty big city now. I remember coming here when my first few records came out, and you did a bunch of tours back then with Heart and Foreigner and Kansas and... did some shows with the Beach Boys, did some shows with Fleetwood Mac. It was real fun.
So if I could organize a show at the Museum of Radio and Television in New York City, you could get a hold of Fleetwood Mac and Foreigner and, whoever else it could be. We could do a whole jamming session there and have all the radio stations in New York come there and do a live broadcast and have all your fans there as well.
Let's do it. Sounds like a band again.
Or as Dan Ingram would say, let's do it to it. Remember Dan?
I remember him well. You were mentioning that, you misspoke ABC earlier, and the thrill for me was when Dan Ingram played Magnet and Steel, because I grew up listening to Dan Ingram.
Oh, yes, Kimo Sabe. It is Dan Regan here on WABC, right? Hey, you.
Yeah. Dan Ingram was the man. He was great, and, Murray the K was great, too, and those guys.
And you're great, too. And I remember John Hall and Larry Hoppen, Lance Hoppen, may he rest in peace.
Larry's the one who's resting, Lance.
Larry, yes. Lance is currently is doing very well.
Yeah, well, he's doing better than his brother, anyway. But I actually did a show with those guys in Jackson, Tennessee about 2 months ago. So, it's been a hard year for my contemporaries, for my peers. Between them, Bob Welch and Levon and,
Did you know Bob Welch?
Yeah, I knew him a little bit. It wasn't like we were big buddies or anything, but,
DN45.
We sort of ran in the same circles. It's awful, and I can remember 20 years ago, like it was last week, and, to think that, 20 years is pretty much of a good optimistic prediction for how much more time we have here. I just want to enjoy it as much as possible. I want to play as much music as possible. One of the other things I do, I'm kind of an all-purpose creative person. I'm a painter. I was an art major at Georgetown. I've written 3 or 4 screenplays. In fact, here's a funny thing. There's a writer named Jeffrey Thomas. Now, Jeffrey Thomas writes in the science fiction horror genre, and he got in touch with me about using some lyrics of mine for one of his upcoming stories that he was writing. And I said, yeah, sure, use it. It was that song, same song, Tunnel of Love, as a matter of fact. And then he came back and he said, well, would you like to be a character in the story? And I said, yeah, by all means. So he wrote this story called Waltered States, in which there's an interdimensional singing duo that is covering one of my songs, and I go to their videotaping of this song, and I get into this big argument with this cantankerous little dwarf-like dummy. It's really hard to explain without giving you the whole thing. But anyway, and then I've actually recently adapted one of his stories, or it's one of his books actually, called Health Agents, into a screenplay, and we're trying to see what we can do with that. So, you got to be creative, and that's really what life is all about as far as I'm concerned.
And when I'm in Atlanta, I'll be listening to Walter Egan. Everybody should go to your website, and when everybody's in Atlanta, they should go to a radio station that Brad knows very well, Z93. WZGZ, the Dollar Bill Game Station of Atlanta, Georgia. I know we've had people listening to from Z93, and I thought Brad would enjoy that. Yeah. Thanks, Walter, very much.
Well,
of course, if they're looking for me, though, they have to come to Nashville because I'm only here for the weekend. I am living outside of Nashville. I mentioned that to you.
Thank you very much.
Oh, yeah, by the way,
my name is Egan, not Egan.
Yeah. I'm getting all the names from
I'm sorry.
I'm in good shape tonight.
I had to throw that in there.
I like the song Walter Egan along with Egan. And now that this is being YouTubed, I got Egan and Egan, and I got the right Hoppins correct, right? Who did what, when, and where, right?
Yeah.
Have a lovely night, Walter Egan and Egan and all the great people of your generation and people of your life, and I hope all your great fans are listening to you. And I got a song for you, WPHD.